I hope you had a good day today, and we're here this evening to continue our series, The Power of Faith. There is no other place to be but this place, because the presence of the Lord is here. And wherever the word of God is proclaimed, powerful things always happen in the name of Jesus. So I want to take this opportunity to say welcome to each one of you to this session this evening. With that in mind, I would also like to remind you that our next session will be tomorrow evening at 7. And then we follow that up on Sabbath at 11 a.m. and again at 7 p.m. But in between those two sessions will be a special program, Young People's Program, that we all joined in with the young people last week. We will have another of those sessions at 5. So we begin to gather ourselves together for 5 p.m. What I want you to do is to spread the word that something wonderful is happening at the Maranatha Church, so they should come and see. We also looking forward to a wonderful day on Sabbath. We just want to clarify with you that the usual live stream will go on Sabbath. We do that weekly. That will take place on Sabbath. So in case you are mistaken, just spread the word for us. So once again, welcome to our program this evening. And may God bless us as we are drawn closer to the kingdom of God. Let's just stand together as we have our opening prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for bringing us together this evening. We just pray and ask that your power will once again attend us, and may souls be born for your kingdom. Thank you for the blessings of the day. Thank you for your forgiveness and your grace. For through Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. This time we will go into our praise and worship with the unit.
Good evening, Maranatha. God is good, and all the time, we serve an awesome God. Do you agree? I know that we can find more than one reason to thank God this evening. From the time we were born until now, God has been faithful. You know, I was reflecting on God's goodness today, and I'm like, Lord, I don't deserve the things that you do in my life, but I praise you and I thank you. And it's because of your love why all the things that I have, the things that I have accomplished, the glory belongs to God. All right, so this evening we are just going to go into our session. I'm flying solo this evening. Other group members are caught up in traffic. So we're going to start by singing, Blessed Be the Name of the Lord.
Running
just run into it, and there I say, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, and there I say, righteous is the name of the Lord. We're now going to the singing of our theme song. Please stand.
New boy. born King, Jesus, the light of the world. We'll walk in the light, beautiful light. Come where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright. Shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world. Jesus, the light of the world. Christ, the everlasting Lord. Jesus, the light of the world.
We'll
walk in the light, beautiful light. Come where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright. Shine all around us by day and by night. Shine bright, shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world.
Shine,
shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world.
Jesus,
Jesus, the light of the world.
The church say amen. Jesus, the light of the world. We are so glad tonight that he is our light and he is our joy. He is our salvation. And tonight, as we have come into this place, we come with our cares, our concerns, our praise. And we just want to tonight just take this next few moments to take it to the Lord in prayer. Are you weary? Are you heavy burdened? Take it to the Lord in prayer. How many of you know that there is power in prayer? Do you believe that? There is power in prayer. Because when we pray, something happens. The one thing Satan does not like is when a child of God gets on his or her knees. Satan trembles. He doesn't like that at all. And so we believe, no matter what it is tonight, I want you to be audacious tonight. I want you to believe in a God who is able to do the impossible. A God who is able to do more than we can ask or imagine. I want you to dare to ask God for the impossible tonight. How many of you need a miracle in your life tonight? You know that what you need, only God can do it. Then it's a good place to be. Because you can't call your neighbor on the telephone for what you need. You can talk to them about it, but they can't fix that problem. Only God can. And so tonight I'm going to ask that you just press toward the front. Just press toward the altar tonight. Jesus is here. And he is about to break some chains tonight. God is about to provide for some financial needs tonight. He is about to bring some weary children home. He is about to restore some strained relationships tonight. Even if you think it's impossible, that's more reason to come to him. The word impossible is just another word that means God can. God knows how to move mountains. He knows how to calm the sea. He knows how to calm storms in our lives. He is able. What do you say? Amen, amen, amen. Somebody say, Pastor, please pray for my health. Please pray for a financial need tonight. And we know that God is able. Another one says, please pray for the employment, my unemployment situation, and for continued health. Pray for my kids, my grandkids, that they will come to know Jesus Christ. Somebody says, Pastor, please pray for my family, especially my daughter. My daughter, especially my daughter tonight. And we remember your daughter tonight. Somebody says, Pastor, Please pray for my son to accept the Lord as his personal Savior before it is too late. And the Lord hears and he understands that cry, my dear. God has been watching out for your son as well. The Bible says his eyes run to and fro throughout the earth, and that's what he's looking for. He's looking to see if there is somebody who will serve him. Please pray for my siblings. And tonight we are bearing that in mind. Pastor, please pray for my family, my father, my brother, my mother, my father-in-law, my siblings, my mother-in-law. And we are praying for your family tonight. Please pray. Somebody else says, please pray. Pray for my ongoing therapy, that God will bring me a complete healing. And we are praying for you tonight. And so just touch somebody where you are. Hold hand with somebody. If we touch and agree, believing that our God is able and that our God will. Now, it's one thing to believe that God is able. How many of you believe that God is able? I know all of you do. That's called faith. How many of you believe that God will? Now that's the next thing. That's belief. I want you to come tonight in faith, and I want you to come believing that our God is here in this place, and that he hears and answers prayers, that he is passing by these pews tonight, and that he'll answer our prayers.
There's a sweet, sweet spirit.
Oh, do you believe that tonight? Oh, he's here. He's here. One by one now, he is passing by each person. Oh, he is the great healer. He is the deliverer. Everybody now reach out to him. Sweet Holy Spirit, reach, sweet Holy Spirit.
There are sweet expressions on each face, and I know they feel the presence of the Lord.
Everybody sing now, sweet Holy Spirit. High and lifted up. Oh, you are God above all. High and lifted up in all the earth is who you are. Lord, we exalt your name tonight. We worship you because you alone are worthy. Indeed, there is none like you. God, tonight we come before you with reverence and godly fear. We know that you are in this place. It is not we who have invited you to come, but you who have invited us to come, because this is your place. This is your house, a holy house of prayer. And we have come tonight, oh God, just to honor the meaning of this place. We come calling upon your name, knowing that you are a God who hears and answers prayer. Lord, tonight there are many requests before me. Many that I have not even read. Many that have not even been expressed here. But you know the desires of every heart tonight, O God. And we just lift them up before you. We have so many different needs tonight, Lord, and needs that nobody else can fulfill, that no one else can satisfy. But we come tonight knowing that if we call on your name, that you will hear us and that you will answer us. You have promised us that if we call on you in the day of trouble, that you will hear us and you will answer us. You have promised us, O Lord, that whatever we need, if we ask, believing in your name, that we will receive. And so we come now, Lord, lifting up our cares and our concerns. You have said that we should cast all our cares upon you because you care for us. And so tonight, Lord, we present to you those who are sick and in need of a healing touch. They're standing here at the altar, and you know who they are. There is somebody who we are praying for tonight who is not even here, but in the hospital right now. And oh God, your spirit who is here is also in the hospital. And so we pray that you'd reach out now and just touch him. Touch her, dear God. We pray that you touch somebody here tonight who got a diagnosis and who has been perplexed ever since. I ask, Heavenly Father, that you would reach out and touch them tonight as only you can. Bring about healing and restoration, we pray. We pray tonight for a relative who, Lord, has gone astray from you. Our hearts have been burdened, and tonight the requests have come. Pray for my son. Pray for my daughter. Pray for my in-laws. Pray for my sister. Oh God, we lift them up before you tonight, and we pray that your spirit will move tonight in this place. And even where they are tonight, we ask that you would go out, oh Lord, and touch them. Draw them to you with cords of love. Father, we pray tonight. You know each person here. You know the burden on every heart. Lord, we ask that you would pass by every person. We pray that you would search every heart. And we ask that you'd pick out the most urgent need of every person. And Lord, we ask that by your grace, by your power, that you touch and you heal. We thank you. We praise you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank God for his power and his presence here this evening. We know our prayers have been heard. At this time, we will be taking up an offering. We pray that as you continue to give to the cause of spreading the kingdom, that God will multiply your blessings. Let's pray. Father, as we give this offering this evening, may your blessing be upon it to the expansion of your kingdom, we pray. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Amen. The Lord is blessing me. The Lord is about to bless us once again through His Word. His clear message found in Scriptures. And we are thankful that the Evangelist Morgan is here with us one more time to present the Word. But before he comes to us, we will listen to the unions as they sing for us.
Anymore, you're the one.
Where's the glasses on that?
Where's the glasses?
Hey, good night, everybody. America, I now talk to people. Me say good night.
Incorrect, man.
Incorrect? To be alive, eh? It's really good to be alive. Some people saw the setting of the sun but didn't see the going down of the same. For that, but my wife called me and gave me the sad news that they broke into our neighbor's house and he pulled his gun and shot one and the other one shot him dead. So he's dead and they don't know where the two guys are. I guess the other one who got shot would not go to the hospital. Hey, but all you have to do to die is to live. Bible says the living know that they shall, but the dead know nothing. And you know, I talked to him about his life and he has like a hotel. Turn his life over to Jesus. As they say in Jamaica, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? Well, we're here tonight. We're going to be here tomorrow night, Friday night. I think we have baptism planned for tonight. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
And I'm making a call again. Oh, I love to do that. That's my joy. And I'm sure they're not going to send you home past 9 o'clock. You know, I'm sure going to send you home past 9 o'clock. When I got to the hotel last night, I couldn't sleep. No, I didn't sleep last night. I slept today. The devil just a liar. So. And ate up some Jamaican food. You know Jamaican food? Banana and yam. But they brought the yellow yam. I do not eat yellow yam. I like Usain Bolt. I want white yam. What you say? So I had some yam and rested today, got to sleep until this pastor provoked me calling my phone. Oh, pastor, somebody bring in lunch to you. Come on, just bring the lunch. Don't call my phone. You see with me, what you see is what you get. You should know me by now. I don't put on. I don't hide. Pastor doesn't mean that I'm different. I'm higher than anybody else. You know?
at the foot of the cross, we are equal. Come on, somebody say amen. Say amen. All right. Well, I'm going to talk to you tonight on the topic Bethesda. But before I do, I'm going to give out some gifts. I don't want to mess up like I did last night. I give out the gifts after the prayer. And I have 4 gifts here. We have 1 person here to be baptized. I hope we can add at least another 4 or 5 more. All in favor, say aye. Those against, say no. The ayes have it. So I want to give out some gifts tonight, but I don't know who the visitors are. So if you are a visitor here tonight, can you come down? If you are a visitor, come on down. Could be a child. Oh, I see one coming. I see 2 coming. Come get a Bible. Plus, I sign them. I sign them and I put a little thing there for you. You feeling cold? What's that?
Yes.
In serious? Can you put on the heat, please? People are feeling cold. Congratulations. Thanks for coming. God bless you. Come on, give a hand, please, in the house of the living God. And here, no, this is the whole family. Okay, so you read the Bible Monday, you read Tuesday. That's okay. God bless you. Thanks for coming. Thanks for coming. Put your hands together for them, please, ladies and gentlemen. And now we have Granny. Granny, you look pretty, boy. Huh? You shopping by Walmart? I saw that dress in Walmart. Girl, I'm joking. I haven't gone to Walmart yet. But I have a Bible here for you. And thank you for coming. You look very nice. Where are you from? Oh, you're Jamaican. You gotta say jam dung. You know jam dung? Whoa, yo. Feel it in the one drop. Yeah, I know you all ain't gonna sing that. You all hypocrite, all you. God bless you. Have a good night. Put your hands together for her, please. Oh, I have more here. I got 2 more. So 2 more guests, please. 2 more guests. Two more guests. I see one is standing. So come on. Oh, you're not a guest. 2 more guests, please. Oh, one is coming. Another come. Come, sweetheart. Come. Don't be afraid. I don't bite. All you think I foolish, right? Come on down. Come on now, little one. Come. You need the Bible too. Come on. Put your hands together for... Yeah. You look scared. You scared? Huh? You scared? You got trembles. You know, like winter when you're cold. Yeah. Look the Bible, darling. You like you want to talk to me. Go on by your business. And I got one more Bible. One more Bible. And that's it for Bibles tonight. The B-I-B-L-E. That's the book for me. I stand alone on the word of God with the B. I, the B-I-B-L-E. Anybody else? Somebody's coming. Okay, come, ma'am. Stand alone on the word of God with the B. All right. That's mother and son. Okay, God bless you. Thanks for coming. I do appreciate. Hello, sir. How are you? You Irie? Irie, man, good to see you. All right? Have a good night, okay?
Yeah.
I could give this to you or mommy?
Yes, for water.
What? Yeah. Want me to give it to you or to your mommy? You take it then, mommy. You take it, you. You're welcome. Put your hands together for them, please, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get into the message. It's quarter past, right? Yeah. Well, I spend time preparing, so when it's nine, that's when I finish. It's bow heads, please, a word of prayer. Yeah, the Lord is my light. Thank you, Lord, for the light. The light in my eyes, my senses. Thank you for smelling and hearing. Thank you for the ability to walk and to eat. We just praise you tonight. We just thank you, Lord, that we are alive. Some saw the rising of the sun, but did not see the going down of the same. But tonight we are in your house and we are alive. Bless the message tonight. May it go forth with power. May it go forth with clarity. And I pray, God, that we have one person to be baptized, that there will be an addition. There will be an addition. Because, Lord, I will appeal tonight. So let your will be done, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. And so tonight I'm making an appeal for baptism. So get ready. Get your children ready. Get your husband, your friend. I love to preach in Africa. I went to preach in Africa, and all you have to say is come. Come, and the translator says, what again? I can't remember. And people run. And where the stage was in Africa is like here, and the people are out in the yard. So they have this big area. And man, when you say come, the guy said Joe, and people run to the altar, man. And that first Sabbath, you baptize 800 plus people. And there are so many, you can't find gowns. And you can't do like America, have scripture reading and all this kind of nice things. You just have to put John, Mary. When it's finished, the whole shoulder is out of place. But God be praised. Amen? Yes, man. That's why the church is growing there. We baptize over 10,000 people in that program. Can't do that in America. All you're too nice. You all have too much. And Seventh Adventist Church in America right now is a mission field. I see it at the highest level. If you take out all the Caribbean people and send them back, you don't have a lot of Americans who are members of the church. Did you hear me? It's Jamaicans, Grenadians, Saint Lucians, and people from the Caribbean. So outside of that, it has become a mission field. Wow. Where the church is growing is in Africa. It's going by leaps and bounds. Come on, somebody say amen. Amen. The great Fitzhenry baptized the most ever in that place. I think over 80,000 people. He called me about two, three days ago, and thank God for grace. Thank God for grace. All right, let's get into the message. And the topic is what? Come on, the topic is on the screen. What's the topic? Bethesda. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Bethesda is a Hebrew word that means house of mercy, a house of grace. Thank God for grace. Amen? Amen. And there are so many Beths in the Bible. There's Bethlehem, which is house of bread. There is Bethany, which is house of dates. House of what? Dates. There is Bethel. Everybody should know Bethel. What's Bethel? House of God. I heard somebody say that. House of God. And then there is Bethesda, which is house of grace. Now, the name of the pool was Bethesda. And it was situated in Jerusalem. Can I tell you, I had the opportunity to go there? I had the opportunity to walk in the pool. Right now, the pool basically doesn't have any water. But the water came up from underneath. And the scholars say that a pool was dug out during the 8th century BC and was called the Upper Pool. So there was the Upper Pool and there was Bethesda, which is the Lower Pool. A second pool was dug during the 3rd century by Simon the High Priest. Just giving you some historical facts here. But these pools were used to wash the sheep. To wash the what? The sheep. Prior to their sacrifice in the temple. And before the sheep was killed or sacrificed, it had to be cleaned. And that's why we have baptism. Come on, somebody say amen. Not part of you go under, but all of you have to go under. And so that's why we don't support sprinkling. Jesus was not sprinkled as a baby. He was blessed. Come on, somebody say amen. He was lifted up by the priest Simon. And then when he got to a certain age, he was baptized. He went under. When the church say amen. And so the use of the pools gave the water of the pool a halo of sanctity. I'm trying to back up here so you can get where I'm coming from. And many invalids came to the pool to be healed. Can I tell you here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, my friends from the Caribbean, especially Jamaica, I know it's a church of Jamaicans. The account begins by saying that there was a feast of the Jews. The Bible says in John chapter 5 and verse 1. Wait, I'm supposed to put it. I keep forgetting. John chapter 5 and verse 1. Go ahead, please, everybody, with the reader, what it says.
After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem.
And so Jesus went up to the feast. Jesus went to church, and it was the Sabbath day. And ladies and gentlemen, the Greek word translated feast indicates that this day was a holy day. And God's holy day still stands. Did you hear me? I said, God's holy day still stands. You want to worship on Sunday, that's your choice. But Sunday is not the Sabbath. Sunday is the first day of the week, and God never blessed the first day. God blessed the seventh day, and God sanctified us. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen. Amen.
And so that's why I keep the Sabbath, not because Adventists keep it. I keep it because God blessed it and God kept it. And what God has done for me, I appreciate. And so what he does, I want to do. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now Jesus, who was a Jew, journeyed to Jerusalem for the feast. Hear me here. Watch the theology. The Passover that Jesus was attending was instituted by him after the deliverance of the people of Israel from Egyptian bondage. And so it is clear, ladies and gentlemen, from scripture that Jesus attended what he would become. My Lord. And so he instituted the Passover. He attended the Passover. And after his death, he became the Passover. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17. Come on, everybody. What it says?
For even Christ or Passover is sacrificed for us.
And so he was sacrificed on the cross. He was nailed what? He was nailed to the cross. He was nailed to the cross. And so it is clear from these texts that his death destroyed the law of Moses. Follow me here. But it did not cancel the law of God. The law of God was not written by any man. Can I walk from this pulpit here? I said the law of God was not written by any man. It was written with the finger of God. And if God writes something with his finger, it has to be important. Anything that God writes has to be important. And when you study deeply, ladies and gentlemen, God did not touch the stone. If God had touched the stone, it would have been destroyed. Moses held the stone and God wrote with his finger. With his what? Finger. And the scripture said he wrote on the front side and the back side of the stone. And if God took time to write, it has to be important. And the Sabbath is not more important than adultery. That's a sin. Lying is a sin. And is anybody here? Worshipping idols is a sin. And refusing to keep God's Sabbath is also a sin. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the scene introduced to us in this passage is a pathetic one. The background is the pool of Bethesda. And around this pool, you find a great multitude of impotent folks. Under my tent, I have anointing. Anointing people come in numbers. And one pastor challenged me and said, anointing must be called for. It must not be asked for. I said, I'm not anointing people because they are sick. I'm anointing them for blessings. Did you hear me? Lady came by me and she said she's in the fourth stage of cancer. She's going to die. I said, bring a bottle of extra virgin olive oil. And I blessed it. I lifted it up to God and I told her what to do and she did it. I saw after she said, Pastor, the cancer is gone. Come on, somebody say hallelujah. Come on, somebody say amen. Can I see here we still have a cancer specialist? The doctors give bad news. And let me tell you something, man. Don't take what one doctor say. Go to a second, go to a third, get a fourth opinion. Because sometimes these machines, they are too hot, they are too cold. Is anybody here? And so they came to Bethesda because the pool of Bethesda was known as a place where miracles of healing occurred. The Bible says in John chapter 5 and verse 3. Come on, reader, let me hear you what it says. Everybody with the reader. After 2:1-2, what it says?
In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk.
Yes, sir.
Of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, they were at Jerusalem. And can I say here tonight that Jerusalem is a place of peace, but there are multitudes that are not peaceful. Well, that was long time, not now. Jerusalem is a place of healing and deliverance, but there are people lying around in bondage. And there are many of us in the church, we are like the people at Jerusalem, we are sick and we go to the Obia man from Jamaica or from Haiti. We forget that there is a God. Is anybody here? Can I say that God still heals? Can I say that God still delivers? The Bible says if you have faith as a, come on, you gotta say it. If you have faith as a mustard seed, all you need is faith and you have it. Yeah, the power of faith. And I think I heard somebody say that faith is the, come on, you don't know the song, faith is the what? Faith is the victory. And so Jerusalem had a Bethesda. We have one here tonight. See, we have a Bethesda too. We have baptism tonight. And you don't have to be perfect to be baptized. Because you see the pastor over there, whatever his name is now, I forgot it now. Lord Jesus. They give me a card to remember all the names. His last name is, I never heard that last name before. I think we need to baptize that name. And so Jerusalem had a Bethesda, but we have one here tonight. And so people are living in error and they need to accept the truth. God cannot have 2 days of worship. It is either Saturday or Sunday. And Sunday was not blessed. Is anybody here? Yes, Saturday was blessed. I baptized a nun. A who? Nun, N-U-N. And she went to the priest and told the priest, asked him, tell me straight up which day is the Sabbath. And he said, Saturday is the Sabbath. But we keep Sunday because of whatever, whatever, whatever. She got baptized. I met her about 3 years ago. I went to Anguilla where she was and she said, come meet my husband. So I said, well, you was a nun, but now you're not getting. And so people are lost and they need direction. And so my friends here in the Maranatha SDA Church, in this narrative, we are simply told that an angel came down at a certain time and troubled the water. Can I say angels are here tonight? In fact, ladies and gentlemen, 1/3 left heaven. So you still have 2/3. Therefore, my brother, for every one angel the devil sends, God sends 2. And the angels of God are powerful. Come on, somebody say amen. Amen. And if you stand for God, they will stand for you. Amen. And so angels drive with us and walk with us. I remember I was in a plane traveling to New York to go and do a crusade. And about 15 minutes into landing, the pilot said, I can't land. It's too much rain and storm. And he flew around 30 minutes. There were some guys on the side there from Trinidad drinking and getting on bad. And they, everybody's serious now. And then he said, well, we cannot land in New York, so we are going to, can't remember the place now, to another place to land. And as we are going there, ladies and gentlemen, the plane is shaking. The plane is what? Shaking. And the luggage on the top, some just dropping out, and people kept bawling, and people were scared. Was I scared? Yes. I'm a human being. You think I want to die? There was a white lady sitting there to me, and she did not even want me to touch her. When I touch her, I had to tell her, I say, watch, it doesn't rub off. But as the plane began its foolishness, she looked at me, she said, because I was singing, and I didn't even know I was singing. I was singing, what a mighty God we serve. Oh, what a, and she said, are you a pastor? And I said, yes. And she grabbed on to me. We landed in Washington, D.C. And when we landed, everybody in the line going to the bathroom. I in the line too. And while I was in the line, I met a guy who I baptized years ago who left the church. And he said, in front of everybody, he made me feel so ashamed. He said, you on the plane? Pastor Morgan, you on the plane? It's because you on the plane that the plane didn't go down, because God ain't finished with you yet. Come on, give God a round of applause here tonight, man. Thank him for his grace. Let's get back to the story. Now, it is not affirmed that the angel did this visibly, and that anyone saw him do it. The Bible says in John chapter 5 and verse 4. Come on, what it says here? For a what?
For an
Come
angel.
On, everybody, after two. One, two.
For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then first after the troubling of the water stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had.
And so this fountain, it seems, had strong medicinal properties. And what is clear to me, however, is this. Whosoever happened, whatsoever I should say, happened at Bethesda that day was special because Jesus, the miracle worker, was at the pool. When Jesus in church, you know. During elections, he's not there. During conference session, when you have to select presidents, he's not there. Is anybody here? But he's there when you have to worship. I say he's there when you have to worship, man. He's there when you lift up hands and you say, hallelujah, hallelujah. There when you have to say, Jesus is all the world to me, my life, my joy, my all. He is my strength from day to day. Without him I should. Oh, you know it? When I am sad, to him I go. No other one can cheer me so. When I am, what he does, he makes me. He's my. Hey, let's go on. I want to get to the sweet part of the sermon. Let's go on. Now, the scripture indicates that the many disabled people who are there were waiting for the moving of the waters. Waiting for the what? And can I say here tonight that there are too many of us who are not making any progress in life because we are just waiting. If you didn't get a husband, so what? Live your life. And some of you make so much style, you ain't getting any anyway. I prefer to have a wife who looks good on the inside and ugly on the outside. I don't believe every one of us should be married. I don't believe maybe I don't know. I say I have an opinion. We are just waiting for God's blessings. And so we're waiting and we go to work on God's Sabbath. It's God's Sabbath, man. Come to church. Did you hear me? Come to church, man. They fired me because I kept the Sabbath. I was a printer. And the newspaper sold out on Friday. And the guy said, I have to print Friday night. I said, I'm a Seventh-day Adventist. When I went back Monday morning, he took a box of matches and lit it. Shh. Tell me, what's that? Pour me. I said, that's fire. I was unemployed for a whole year. Did you hear me? Man, to eat, I had to go and catch fish. But thank God for grace. The same place they fired me from, they called me back. Because they couldn't fix the press, but I could fix it. Now you want me back, you got to come. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you. Used to pay me $200 a fortnight, it went up to $4. Come on, somebody say amen, man. And 6 months after, the production manager died. Who you think was next in line? I was next in line. From $400 a fortnight to $4,000+ a month. When you stand up for Jesus, he will stand up for you. He will never let you down. Come on, somebody say amen. Hey, stand up for Jesus. No matter what's wrong. Pam, 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 pam. Stand up for Jesus. Even death comes along. Bam, 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 bam. Stand up for Jesus. No matter what's wrong. Stand up, stand up, stand up strong. Woo-hoo-hoo.
Waiting around will not solve the problem. The main character in the story had been waiting for 38 years. This means he was in that condition before Christ was born. And so the great physician approaches this crowd of sufferers who were not only sick but helpless. And so when Jesus saw him lying there, he asked him, "Do you want to get well?" What a question. Why is he asking a lame man whether he wants to get well? I believe, ladies and gentlemen, that Jesus asked the question because he was surprised to see the man there.
How did he get there? If he's impotent, someone has to take him there. So they take him and left him. I told my wife, when I get old, don't put me in no house. No. What do you call it? I pay to build this house. Get somebody to take care of me. Is anybody here? If I pee in my pants, put on Pampers. And let me see here, we got to learn to treat our parents well. I said, we got to learn to treat them well. Some of us just dash them away like if they are some potato. But we got to treat them well. When you love your mother and your father and treat them well, God blesses you. And nobody can bless you like God. Come on, somebody say amen. When God blesses on top, below, around, behind. And nobody can take away the blessing. Come on, somebody say hallelujah. How did he get there? And if no one is there to help him, and he's feeble, he would never get in the pool. And so the man was waiting around, expecting something to happen. Yeah. I want you to note something, Mr. Organist. Jesus singled him out. There's a whole lot of them been there. Let me speak proper English. A whole lot of them were there. But Jesus singled him out. A whole lot of people here tonight, more than last night, but God is pointing you out. God is saying, when the appeal is made, you must come to the altar. You have been making style for too long, and those of you who have left the church for whatever reason, it's time to come back. Come on, somebody say amen. Jesus Jesus did not address the whole congregation. And he did not heal the whole group. Jesus always addresses one person at a time. He did that with Nicodemus. He did that with the woman at the well. She was at the well, but she wasn't well. And watch it. To do it with the woman at the well, he had to send the disciples away. Because if they were there, they would want to say, the master, Pastor Morgan talking to a prostitute. I baptized a prostitute in a certain country. And every night she comes, she have on revealing clothes, but she comes and she hugs me. I hug her back, my wife right there. The pastor called me in his office. I don't like how you hugging her. But I got so vexed, I almost cussed. And when I get vexed, I stutter. I say, in fact, from tomorrow night, you preach. Who the hell? You can tell me who to hug? On the final Sabbath in the morning. We are shaking hands. He's at the left, I'm at the right. He's at the left, I'm at the right. When we looked, we saw the girl. She got a job in a nursing home. Pink skirt. You hear me? Pink hat, pink bag, pink shoe, top to match. The pastor did not even allow me to shake the girl's hand. He went out. Oh, so good to see you. Oh, yes, we like them when they are cleaned up. Oh, we like them when they are holy. But God takes them anyhow. Everybody deserves a chance. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen. Amen. Yes.
She's still in the church? Her husband is a Jamaican. Flew to New York and married them. Come on, somebody say amen, man.
Amen.
Come on, somebody say amen. Come on, give the Lord a hand in the house of the living God, man.
Yes.
One person at a time. Tonight, I believe that Jesus is speaking to individuals. And when I wrote this last night, I just sat back in the chair and thought a while. Jesus is saying, do you want to be made whole? There are too many sick people in the church. Pastor, I'm not seeing the senior pastor. But I believe from my reading of the Bible that we should have anointing services every quarter. Not just communion. Anoint the church. I did that in New York and in Queens every Sabbath. Not every Sabbath, every special Sabbath. The pastors have anointing. There's something special about it. Come on, somebody, is anybody here?
Amen. Amen.
And so the answer of the sick man was very pathetic. Was what? Pathetic. The Bible says in John 5 and verse 7, hear what he says. Come on, sir, what he said?
Sir,
uh-huh.
I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but when I am coming, another steppeth down before me.
And so he said, when I'm coming in, another one steps down before me. He's ready to blame other people for his inability to get into the water. Yeah. I ain't blaming nobody. Me come in church. You hear me? Yeah. And I tell people, even if you have sex Friday night, come church on Sabbath. Yeah. Everybody needs the benefit of the doubt. Come on, somebody say amen. Amen. We have too much Pharisees in the church. And most of them in the eldership.
Yes.
Everybody deserves the benefit of the doubt. Look at the woman at the well. Look at the woman caught in the. I am here because a pastor gave me a chance. The church board voted no. The pastor voted yes. And the elders almost killed him. But I'm still here. Did I fall down? Yes. But I didn't stay down. I got back up. Come on, somebody say amen, man. Because when we fall down, we get up, because there's a Jesus. I'm gonna feel like jumping and dancing, but you all might think I'm crazy. But when we fall down, we get back up, because there's a Jesus who loves us. Too many of us are not doing well. We make the faults of others an excuse for our neglect of duty. Do not become a failure because of others. Stop complaining. God has been good. God has been what?
Good.
Some of you came from Jamaica, you have red card, blue card, no green card, but you're here still. And God has blessed you. Come on, somebody say amen. Some of you left your wife in Jamaica and come over here and get married. Anybody throwing stones? And so Jesus said to him, "Rise. Take up your bed and..." Jesus did not lift him up. He did not touch him. He did not push him down. He spoke to the faith in the man. That shows the power of faith, man. Jesus said, "Rise." All verbs. Take up your bed. And what? And walk. And the man did not complain. "Oh, but I have not walked for 38 years. The man was down for so long. He just got up, took up his bed and walked. And he did not know who spoke to him. He did not leave like the man in the temple. Different personalities we have, we? I don't expect to see this pastor dancing. He looked too. You can interpret that. But me? Hey, the woman of Samaria, the woman. She left she water pot and she gone. The woman of Samaria, the woman. She left she water pot and she gone. Jesus said she had five. She said she have none. She left she water pot and she gone. Jesus said she had five. She said she have none. She left she water pot and she... Hey, the woman of Samaria, the woman. She left, she water pot and she... And so Jesus told him, "Take up your bed. Walk." And he did not know who told him to walk. In fact, ladies and gentlemen, I think I have it on the screen. In fact, he did not only... Come on, you gotta say it. He did not only
walk,
but he walked away. As the Bajan say, he left. Yes. He left Bethesda. Bethesda was his place of healing, but he must leave. But if I were Pentecostal, I speak in tongues. Hiya, shita, hata, hey. Jesus did not pray for him. Jesus did not help him to get into the water. Rather, Jesus spoke to the potential in the man.
Yes.
You have ability. Do something about it.
Yes.
I'm a pastor today because Jesus spoke to me. Yeah. No bright boy. I was kicked out of school in Farm 3. I tried CA, I was GC at the time. Accounts, commerce, and English. I got a D, a E, and a U. You know what U means? Ungraded. I came into church, I just used to sing. Write songs, you know, I get and sing. He is not dead. He is risen. Long ago, he ascended into heaven to meet his Father, our loving Master, and will come again to receive you unto himself. Hear the chorus now. So I wanna be there to see where they pierce the side. I wanna be there, oh yeah, yeah, to see where the nails did ride, the thorns they laid on his head, and the blood that he shed. I wanna be taken up to Calvary and see that place where he died for me. I wanna see Adam, Moses and Jonah. Oh, I wanna be there, I wanna be there, and I got to be there. Woohoo! And so Jesus said, pick up your mat and walk. Jesus' job was not to lift him up. You can do it. Rise, man. Come on, man. Doesn't have to speak to you. You know you're living in sin. When the call is made, come. I say what? Come. I baptized the mighty sparrow. Just two conversations. He never saw me. I never saw him. His daughter called and gave me the number and said, talk to him. Get him to come to the crusade. We kept talking. Just good talk. And then one day I drop it like it hot. He said, really? You want me to get baptized? I said, yeah, I'd like to baptize you, man. He's from Trinidad. During that time, the church was going through some rocket in Trinidad. Did you hear me? One of the pastors did some nonsense. Every newspaper. But God knows how to save his church, boy. Yes. It wasn't no scandal. He did it. Scandal. I say he did it. And so his daughters came to see me at the tent the Sabbath morning from 9 o'clock. They spoke to me until 10:30. All I did was, I've learned that. Through visiting, when you go visit people, pastor, where you gone? You don't talk, you? And I'm praying. Because they're saying he's not ready yet. He don't even know John 3:16. They're true. The guy knows nothing. All you know is Jean and Dinah, Rosita and Clementine. And then the Lord just inspired me and I said to her, if you allow me to baptize him, I'll stay with him. Yeah. I'll text him, I'll call him, I'll never leave him. She said, you'll do that? I said, yes. Yeah. She said, well, baptize him. I called my wife and the guy said, go and get Sparrow. Sparrow came under the tent. Yeah. And I got to make it big. You hear me? I'm baptizing him in no pool. I'm going to the sea. The sea is 2 hours away. Is anybody here? Yeah. And when we got to the sea, we had to lift him down on a long stretcher because he couldn't walk. He walked with a walker. And there are 5 pastors in the sea holding him. And he heavy. The pastor said, Moggy, come, he heavy. But I waiting for the thing to go up now. The views to go up. But Moggy come, I said, wait until the views. The secretary came, she said, pastor, 1 million people are viewing. I said, now it's time to baptize him. Come on, somebody say amen, man. Come on, somebody say amen, man. It's not how you start, it's how you finish. I said, it's how you finish. And God loves you. God is not willing that any should perish, but that some should come to repentance. And so believe it or not, the man participated in the miracle. John chapter 5 and verse 8. Do I have it? Yes, it's there. Come on, everybody at the reader. What it says here?
Jesus said unto him, rise, take up thy bed, and walk.
Now Jesus asked him to pick up his mat. But what is the mat? It was a bed. The scholars say, as I searched last night, it was a light mattress. A light what? And so I said to myself, I have to apply this. And so the mat is whatever has been your comfort zone.
Yes.
Can be liquor. Can be smoking. The mat is whatever you have been using as an excuse for not walking to victory. Take up your mat. The mat is whatever has kept you chained down in mediocrity. Come on, take up your mat. The time has come for you to do something special about your life. Come on, man. I say, come on, man.
Yes.
And so Jesus is saying to someone here that you have more in you than you realize.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
That's why I'm in the ministry. How to do GED. GE what?
GED.
I look at the questions, I don't even know a thing. But my wife said, two are very wrong and two are very close. I found out those that were very wrong and those that were very close, I just say, in Jesus' name. And we are off to college. The girl has 9 subjects, I have 0. They said to her, where you going with him? He's a dunce. I said, no, 9 plus 0 are 9. And I went to college. I took it back in basic English. Big man like me. 31 years old, I went to school. 18, 19. I am, you are, she is there. But weeping and joys for a night. Come on, somebody. But what comes in the morning? Joy. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Come on, you got to sing it here. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Come on, sing it. Take my hands, Lord. Touch my heart, Lord, speak through me. If you could use anything, Lord, you can use me. Come on, let me hear you sing it. I don't sing it. Come on, sing. If you can sing it now, sing. You can use me. I sing.
Take my hand, Lord, and my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak to me.
If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. I just want you to note the 3 verbs. The time is closing. I want you to know note the 3 verbs. What's the first one?
Rise.
That represents physical healing.
Yeah.
Jesus is my deliverer. Jesus is my deliverer. Physical. Jesus
is my deliverer. I know he delivers.
You don't feel like dancing? What's the next one?
Take.
Take up your bed symbolizes a break with the past.
Yeah.
I have decided.
I have decided to follow Jesus.
I have decided
to follow Jesus.
No turning back. And what's the last one? Everybody must say the last one. What's the last one?
Walk.
Walk symbolizes Christian growth. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing
Jacob's ladder.
We are climbing
Jacob's ladder.
We are soldiers. I'll just stop every time you're always singing with me. Now follow me here. I'm going to close. Have a few more minutes. He did not tell him to arise and go home. It was the Sabbath day. And now that he is whole, he must go to the synagogue. Pastor, I got to put in this one. As a Jew, he knows that it is unlawful for a Jew to carry his bed on the Sabbath day. But he was instructed. What is the verb? He was what? Instructed by the Lord Jesus to carry the bed, and he did not hesitate. Unknowing to the paralytic, he was about to become the center of attention of the Jewish leaders who saw him carrying his bed. They hold no punches. And so they told him, come on, read it. What did they tell him? Come on, everybody. What did they tell him?
It is the Sabbath day.
Uh-huh.
It is not lawful for thee to carry thy bed.
The Jews did not ask him, who healed you? There's some people in the church who are not concerned. Therefore, he did not answer their question concerning the Sabbath. The Bible says in John chapter 5 and verse 11. Come on, what it says? He what? He told them, he that made me
whole,
the same one said, take up your bed and
walk.
How do you interpret that? He is saying, you have never been able to heal me. Therefore, I say to you, you have less authority than he does. I'm coming now. He told me to carry my bed, and I am carrying my bed.
Yes.
The man's reason, in fact, the man reasoned correctly. Because watch it, put it. I have it there, Lord. Put it. Yes. Come on, everybody. What it says. If Jesus what?
If Jesus had power to work so singular a miracle, he had the right to explain the law.
And the explanation is clear. Hear this. God made the Sabbath for man, but he never intended. I think I have it there, Lord Jesus. I have it there. God made the Sabbath for who?
Man.
But he never intended the Sabbath to impose hardship on mankind. Man. So if you're hungry, don't stay home and lie down in your bed on the Sabbath and get gas. Go by and buy something to eat. If you came in from Jamaica Friday night and the pants crimple, iron the pants. You cause more tension with a crimp. Is anybody here?
Yes.
I says, anybody here?
Yes.
I think that Jesus healed a man on the Sabbath with full knowledge that it would make the Pharisees mad.
Yes.
He wanted to expose the hypocrisy and false legalistic tradition. Now follow me here as I close. The most important lesson in this story is the man's innocence. From a paralyzed man, he is now the center of attention.
Yes.
Come on, somebody say amen, man. When I became Adventist, I was the center of attention. Everybody wanted to see me. All the Sunday pastors, we need to talk. I headlined the news. Top Calypsonian becomes Christian. And they laugh. And they said, oh, he's just going there for a woman. Huh? And the woman I have, I didn't meet her in the church. When I came in the church, the girls want to take me out. And when we come back, they want money. If it's that you call it. The one that I married now, who's my wife, she was Pentecostal. I brought her in. Come on, somebody talk to me, man.
Amen. Amen.
And when we were lying and I passed, I went and I touched her trying to get a kiss. She said, you take your hands off. God knew what I would become. She wanted me to have a woman that when I'm out here, she's... Come on, somebody say amen. Man. Let me close the thing. I see Pastor like he vexed. And so from Bethesda, he journeys to the temple. He journeys to the what?
The temple.
Where doubtless he was thanking God for the miracle. Now when Jesus found the man later in the temple, he said to him, John chapter 5 and verse 14. What he said to him?
Privilege always...
No. What? No, look at here. What he said to him?
Afterwards, Jesus findeth him in the temple and said unto him, Behold, thou art made whole. Sin no more, lest a worse thing come unto thee.
And so you can read the last one. The last one says, privilege always bring with it what?
Responsibility.
You have a responsibility to God to be faithful to him.
Yes.
Streaming or not, bring your tithe and offering to church is not yours.
Yes.
And you're not paying me. It's God's tithe. It's God's own. And God's when you bring it, he'll open the windows of heaven. Come on, somebody talk to me, man. When Jesus said sin no more, he was expressing God's standard of holiness. God cannot and will not condone sin.
Amen.
Did you hear me?
Yes.
I'm moving down to one of the greatest things I want to say. And so watch this. Come on, read it, reader. What it says? God what?
The greatest miracle.
Not that one.
But that's what you have. Right?
No, not that. I'm rushing. Now, read that one. What it says?
God created us to get up and walk, not to lie down and disappointment.
Yes. Come on, can you read it again?
God created us to get up and walk, not to lie down in disappointment.
And so spiritually speaking, many people are lying down. Lying what?
Down.
Paralyzed by their sins.
Yes.
Some because of a pastor. What pastor do? What pastor say? Huh? I don't care what they say. You hear me? They call me gay. I gay, yes.
And happy.
Yes, sir.
They tell me I love to dance too much. I went to a church to preach. The elder said, we don't want no dancing in here. Put me in the pulpit and close the door. But if you get, you could spin. When I was finished, she said, that's what they're talking about? I said, I don't know. But I'm just being myself. Come on, somebody say amen. Come on, give the Lord a hand in the house of the living God.
Amen.
Hey, God loves you.
Yes.
Do you love him?
Yes.
If you love him, put up one hand. Just one. If you really love him, put up both hands. Yeah. Keep them up. Don't drop them yet. Yeah. If you love him enough to keep all his commandments, stand to your feet.
Yes.
We have a baptism today.
Yes.
Tonight.
Yes.
Is there anybody who would like to join her? We get you ready. We don't wet your clothes down. Is there a mother who would bring a child? Is there a backslider who will come back? Is there somebody who will join her? I think I see somebody coming. Hey, look, Ali, look. Somebody's coming.
Yes. Yes.
How many more will join her tonight? Come. Vinny. How many more will join her tonight? God bless you as you come, man. You didn't come to do it tonight, but that's how it is with God, man. If you can die tonight, you can give him your heart tonight. Father, won't you bring your son? Mother, won't you bring your daughter? Backslider, won't you come back? Don't be ashamed. Huh? Oh, yes, they talk, but after a week, the talk finish. As I say come, you can feel it.
Yeah.
As I say come, some of you feeling cold, some of you feeling hot. Just come. Start your children right. It's not how they start, it's how they finish. God bless you as you come.
Yeah.
God bless you as you come. I'm holding out for you. Mama, bring your children. Bring them to Jesus. Somebody's coming. I know it after 9, but this is important. This is what? You want me to lead you down? Just raise your hands. I'll come for you. You want me to walk with you down the aisle? Just raise your hands. I'll come for you.
Savior is waiting.
God bless you as you come. If somebody's coming, I can feel it. Somebody's coming. Somebody is coming.
Won't you let him come in?
It's just one step. It's just one step. Tonight can be your last.
In this world,
why die in sin when you can die in Christ? Won't you give him a chance? Won't you give him a chance tonight?
Answer to
him. Oh, I love to do this. I can do this all night, you know. Time after time, sing it. Music, please, the music. I'm going to walk from the back right to the front. When I get to the front, I finish. As I walk, and if God speaks to you, just walk behind me. I will not speak, I will just walk. I finish walk.
Yeah.
I've done my part, haven't I?
Amen.
You want to sit tonight? God, keep me.
Yes.
Raise your hands, please. Raise it up high. You want to say, God, I'm a member of the church. I'm a Seventh-day Adventist. Give me the strength to help somebody come to Christ this week. Raise your hands up. You're not a Seventh-day Adventist, but you want to say, Pastor, one of these days, pray for me. Put your hands high. God bless you. We give God thanks to the sister and the son who came. I don't know what pastor will do, but you take it from here.
I want to offer a special prayer.
Oh, you're going to pray? Okay,
yeah. Keep standing.
I'm sorry about that.
I want to offer a special prayer for Tajay tonight. Tajay needs medical attention, has a tumor. And they have come to the house of the Lord tonight. So I want you to join me now as we just bow our heads in prayer. As we pray this prayer, you feel impressed that you just want God to do something special in your life too. Feel free. Just come on down. Come on down. Come on down and join me here. If you feel impressed that you want God to just touch you, just do something in your life. I don't know what you've been praying for. But I don't know what you've been going through, but you want God to touch you as well. Just come on down. Just come on down. Just come on down. As close as you can to the front so we get everybody as close as they possibly can be. Many have come, not because we called, but because they have heard your voice. We know that you are here. And truly, our only help is you. You brought us here tonight. You took us from where we were. And you brought us to this place. We have come to you tonight. Asking, O Lord, for a touch from you. We pray that you would move in this place, in this moment. God, we ask that you would do what only you can. We present little Tajay before you now. Oh God, we pray that you would touch him as only you can. What we're asking you to do tonight, Lord, is beyond what any human being can possibly do. There are some needs represented at this altar tonight. God, only you can, only by your divine touch, can we experience healing and deliverance. And so, Father, tonight, you know how the enemy has worked over time to inflict pain, to wound and to control and to capture. Tonight, Lord, we pray for deliverance. We ask that you'd release his grip. We pray that you'd rebuke him, O God. And we ask that in the name of Jesus, you would speak deliverance. You would speak peace. You would speak healing. You would speak redemption. We pray for this little lad tonight, O God, that you would touch him. You know exactly what's going on. Doctors have tried and they haven't quite been able to rectify the situation yet. But tonight he's here. His mother has brought him to you. We've seen this happen over and over in Scripture. And Lord, you know exactly what to do. So tonight, oh God, we lift him up to you. And we ask that by your mighty power, you would touch him and bring healing. Pray for somebody who's here tonight who needs healing in mind and spirit. God, we pray that you'd bring that healing, that clarity. Bring them to a place, oh God, of complete deliverance. We thank you for hearing us. We thank you for blessing us. In Jesus' name, let the church say, amen and amen. Just keep standing right where you are. I think we're ready for the baptism. Tonight we are delighted. Sister Enid Thompson has been coming. And tonight she has decided to completely lay down everything and surrender all to Jesus Christ. What a wonderful moment this is. Isn't this wonderful? There is no feeling like this when you just lay everything down. There's somebody here tonight who needs to do the same. And I'm praying that she will be a source of inspiration to you. And so, Sister Enid, God has been so good to you, has been leading you on this journey. And tonight you have made that full surrender. So because you have confessed your love for the Lord Jesus Christ, upon the profession of your faith in him, we as ministers of the gospel now baptize you in the name of the Father, of his Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let the church say, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Tomorrow night is the last night. Tonight is Thursday, right? Tomorrow night, the topic is Veronica. And then Sabbath morning, the topic is blind and lonely. I haven't come up with one for Sabbath evening yet. But this is the end of the program, am I right? Right. And so on, well, no, the whole crusade. This is the last weekend. And so I ask you please to bring a special offering on Sabbath to defray the expenses. Did you hear me? Come good. Oh God, no dollar, no $5. Put a good bit of, and I'm praying that whatever you put, God will give you back 3 times. Did you hear me? And so come on Sabbath to give a special offering to defray the expense, my ticket coming here, hotel, and stuff like that. And even though it was last minute, I'm glad that I did come. Amen? That I did come. The pastor wants me to come back in October. I'm trying to work it out. I'm really trying to work it out. I looked at my calendar and I'm trying to work it out. But it's good to be here. Thanks for coming. God bless you. Let's stand as we sing, as we say the Lord's Prayer together. And that is the dismissal part of the service. Let's stand, please. Our Father, you remember, right? Let's go. Our Father who art in heaven, come thy will be done as it is in heaven. Give us this day our and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into but deliver. For thine is the kingdom, forever and ever. Come on, hug no less than 3 people tonight. Show your hands around somebody. You are dismissed. Thanks for coming. Bring a friend tomorrow night. Tomorrow night I'll be making another appeal for baptism. God bless you. Show your hands around somebody. Sing, sing.
Walk in the light, beautiful. child.
Come on, sing it.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
Oh, let it shine,
let it shine, let it shine.
Yes, yes. Hey, on a Sunday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Monday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Tuesday,
I'm gonna let it shine.
On a Wednesday,
I'm gonna let it shine.
On a Thursday,
I'm gonna let it shine.
On a Friday,
I'm gonna let it shine.
On the Sabbath, He gave me the power divine to let my little light shine. This little light of mine,
I'm gonna let it shine.
Oh, this little light of mine,
I'm gonna let it shine.
Little light of mine,
I'm gonna let it shine.
Oh, let it shine,
let it shine, let it shine.
My God is able, He's
able.
I know He is able.
I know my Lord is able to carry me through.
Come on, you gotta sing it now. He's able. Broken hearted and said,